Don't try to give no motivational speech, 'cause all I wanna do is live on the beach. I play golf once a week and I surf all I can. I'm an overeducated deliverer.
You are not making this easy for me. I'm so sorry, but there's someone else. I can't continue this.
Stop!
I'm sorry, was I not expressive enough?
You were just fine. Really convincing, actually. Mike, why are you laughing? It is an intense moment after he confesses his love to her.
Look, I'm sorry, dude. It's just that she's up here being all sexy, and then he does all this crap for her, and then she dumps him in front of everybody for another guy at the party. I mean, who does that? I mean, that doesn't really happen.
You do realize it's about his life, you dumbass.
She's right, you know.
About what?
These are all true stories about my life. And you may be a really great actor, but you are a dumbass.
Alright. I'm sorry, man. The stories are funny and all, it's just that how can all this stuff all really happen?
You just need to learn how to move on, as hard as it is. You can't let your personal situations affect your schoolwork or your sports. You have way too much potential. You need to learn how to balance it out. It's not easy, but this is probably going to happen to you more than once in your life. Just like my friend.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Thanks for the talk, Mr. A.
It's my job.
I need to talk to you.
Can't you see I'm with a student here?
Oh, sorry. Sorry for interrupting, kid, but I need to talk to my friend about something important.
It's not a problem.
This is my friend Jack. Jack, this is one of my students, Joe.
Oh, so this is the guy.
Hey, dude.
Sorry about that.
Sorry about what?
Here's a pass to go back to class. Any more problems, you come and see me.
Yeah, thanks, Mr. A. Oh, and, I'll work on it. Don't worry.
Why does that kid act like he knows me?
Well, he's having some women problems, and, I was helping him out by telling him some of your crazy women stories.
Oh, I am so glad my mishaps are being used to educate America's youth.
So, why are you coming to my work disrupting a session with my student?
I talked to her.
Who?
It's cold. I got no money, but I got a good tan. I'll be your overeducated delivery man.
The story of love and hate relations involves four people. First, there's the loving couple. That's Adam and Diane. They have two best friends, Colleen and Sean. They've known each other their whole lives, but they hate each other's guts. They're always at each other's throats, but they always seem to be around each other in some form. Now, the couple always wants to hang out with the two of them. Whenever they go out, they start a ruckus. All this stuff happens. They're telling old stories. They're always fighting. So Adam and Diane are just fed up with it. And one night, they throw this party, kind of ready to be engaged type of party. And they lock their two best friends in a basement in a wine cellar all night long to iron out their differences. So they're downstairs fighting and arguing in this small space, and there's wine all over the place. So they start drinking the wine and saying their true feelings for each other, while upstairs the party's going on and an uninvited ex-girlfriend of Adam's shows up. So there's a lot of bickering. It's very scriptive, and I would say it's kind of like half romantic comedy and half unromantic comedy. But I hope you really enjoy it, and please, if you have anything to donate for us so we can create this, anything is appreciated. Thank you so much.